Good morning. In this video, we will discuss another CPU scheduling algorithm, which is shortest job first scheduling algorithm. In short, you can say it shortest job first, SJF. Okay. We will be. What is the idea of shortest job first? Is in the ready queue, we will be having a list of processes waiting for execution. So the scheduler picks the next shortest job for execution. Okay, actually that's the idea. It picks the shortest job and schedule it to the CPU. So that's the idea of a shortest job scheduling. Okay, assume that the same question for the previous algorithm what we discussed, we are going to discuss it again. Assume that you have the following jobs. These are the jobs, processes in the ready queue to execute with one processor. Okay, with the jobs arriving in the order listed here. So these are the processors, five processors, and their corresponding burst time, the CPU execution time. It needs this much millisecond for execution each process. Now the question is, suppose a system uses shortest job first, SJF scheduling, create a Gantt chart illustrating the execution of these processes. Okay, so as I mentioned, in the shortest job first, okay, assume that the arrival time of all the processes is zero. Okay, but they are all arriving in the order listed here, but the arrival time is zero. They all come in 0th millisecond. Okay, now which process has to be started? We need to go with the smallest job. So among these five, the smallest is P2. Okay, so P2 starts execution because it needs only 10 milliseconds for execution. So P2 will finish its execution at time 10. After that, you have 80, 20, 20, 50. But 80 and 50 are big. So you have two processes, P1 and P3, with the same time. Okay, remember, whenever you have more than one processes with the same time, you need to go with which comes first. So you need to pick the one which comes first, because the question says jobs arrive in the order. So it comes in this order: 0 first, process 1 next, process 2 next, process 3 next, and the 4 is the last. Okay, so you need to choose P1. So at time 10, P1 starts its execution. It needs only 20 milliseconds. So 10 plus 20, 30 milliseconds. Here comes this process, P3. And it also needs 20 milliseconds. So at time 50, it finishes its execution. After that, P4 starts its execution. And at time 100, this one finishes its execution. And the last process, of course, P0. At 180 millisecond, P0 finish its execution. So this is the Gantt chart showing how the execution of jobs will be. Okay, now let's move on to the next question. What is the turnaround time for process P4? So I'm not going to stick to P4 only. I'm going to explain for all the processes, even the average turnaround time, because I'm going to use here for all the process. I can cross check. Okay then, so what is the turn? Because I have to use for average waiting time, the turnaround time, I need to use it here. So that's another reason. Okay then, so the formula for turnaround time. Is equal to the completion time minus arrival time. Okay, so let's start to do with the process P0. Completion time, I need to see the Gantt chart so that you can able to understand. Now I'm going in the sequence P0, P1, P2. I'm going in the same sequence. Here you see that P0 finish at 180 millisecond. Arrival time is 0. So The turnaround time is for P0 is 180. So turnaround time for P1, let's see, P1 is here. Completion time is 30. See, what does it mean, completion time? At what time P1 finished its execution? P1 starts at time 10 and finish at time 30. So that is the thing. Arrival time, I just mentioned all the process arrive at the same time, but in the order. Okay, so 30. Turnaround time for P2 is here. It finish at time 10 and the arrival time 0, so it's 10. Turnaround time for P3 is here. 50 is the completion time, 0 is the arrival. Turnaround time for P4, the last process, it's here. 100 is the completion time minus 0, then 100 again. Now let's move on to average turnaround time. So as I mentioned before, average means you need to sum up all the turnaround time divided by the number of process. So you have 180, 30 plus 10 plus 50, and the last one is 100 divided by, there are 5 processes in the system. So the answer will be 74. Okay, the last question. What is the average waiting time for the process? So actually we need to know the formula to calculate the waiting time. Waiting time is equal to turnaround time minus the burst time, the CPU time. Okay, so let's do for P0. P0 turnaround time, you just calculated in the above question. So 180 minus P0, the burst time is 80. So it's 100. Waiting time for P1. Turnaround time is 30 minus 20, that is 10. Waiting time for P2, turnaround time is 100. Even the burst time is also 10. Sorry, turnaround time is 10. Burst time is also 10. 10 minus 10, 0. Waiting time for P3. So turnaround time is 50. And then the burst time 20. So you get 30. The last one, turnaround time for P4. Sorry, this is waiting time for P4. Turnaround time is 100, your burst time is 50, then that's equal to 50 again. So let's do the average. Sum them all. So 100 plus 10 plus 0 plus 30, and then the last one is 50 divided by 5. 5 is the total number of process. When you divide, you will get 38. So this is about the another CPU scheduling algorithm, shortest job first. Thank you.